Hi everyone, I'm here today with Emma Murray-Jones, who is a luxury wedding and event planning specialist. Hi Emma, how are you today?
I'm really great, Maria. Thank you so much for having me. I'm so excited to be here with you today.
So where are you in the world and why are you there?
So right now I am in the south of Spain, and as you can see, it's very sunny. It's a beautiful day. I'm here at the moment just spending time with my family, I think. For me, one of the positive things of coronavirus is that, as we all know, working in the events industry, we work crazy hours, we work really long hours, and seeing family isn't always possible. So I've really taken advantage of the moment to be here and to work remotely from Spain.
What is it that you love about the event industry, and how did you get started?
I fell into events by chance. After university, I did a food and beverage management training program at the Ritz, and I spent 6 months of that program working in the events department, and that's kind of where I really realized that I loved events. I loved seeing the start to finish element of it and seeing it come together. I think it's really rewarding to see all your hard work come to life, and also when you've really touched somebody and they've had a wonderful time. For me, there is no better feeling than knowing that all of your hard work and effort has been appreciated and you've created something special for your client. The first event I ever did was in my final year of university. I helped with two other students. We helped support the planning and the running of the Leeds Chinese Community Association Chinese New Year event. That, I suppose, was the first event that I was really involved in. And again, I also loved that as well. And I loved thinking about the client journey.
And what is it that you find the most challenging about working in events?
I would say working with others, and also the fact that sometimes something can go wrong and it's not that you have no control, or it's not your fault. I think working with others, whether it be a client, colleagues, different vendors, everybody works in a different way. So obviously working with a client, you can have difficulties there managing expectations. They may have things going on in their lives that might mean that they might be have different attitudes or emotions towards things. It's really important to be understanding and aware of that. Working with people within your team, always need to be respectful and work at same speeds. But, as well, working with vendors as well, different suppliers for the events can be a challenge, because everybody works in a different way. Everyone has different priorities. Everyone has a lot going on. So it's managing all of those different types of relationships and getting the information and bringing everything together can be a challenge. And as well, on the day of the event, if there's a power cut, again, managing that situation and turning into as much of a positive as possible is always a challenge. And I think that's something that everyone in events, we slightly love the adrenaline, we're on this, the day of the event, we need to make it right. This needs to happen. This has gone wrong. Fix this. We run over, speak to chef, it's about reacting to the situation. And that sometimes can be challenging.
And on the flip side of that, what is it you find the most rewarding about working in events?
The most rewarding for me is when a bride and groom sits down after the wedding or a client after any event. And I had one bride, and the groom said after the wedding, his words were, it was magical. And we spent about a year planning, and we had gone into a lot of detail, and they were the loveliest couple, but it was just that moment, when I knew that I had done a good job and the family had enjoyed it, and the friends, and it was everything they wanted. That for me is kind of it. That there's no higher kind of like praise or anything that I'm looking for, because that for me just means that I've done something for them, and it's a memory that they will carry with them forever.
Oh, that's really lovely. And you've had a range of different roles in luxury wedding and events.
Yes.
In the industry. So what's been your favourite job so far?
I think that's a super hard question to answer. I've loved different elements of every job I've had. I've learnt new things in every area, so that's been amazing for me. I think it's really important to always keep growing and keep learning within the industry and keep being aware of what's happening around you. I loved working at the Ritz because for larger events, you would combine different rooms together, just given the size of the spaces. And that was really interesting, helping create a journey for the bride and tailoring their wedding day or corporate event to the spaces. Similarly, with Marriott, I loved working there as well, because I was working across five different venues. So that was very exciting, very different. And then as well, what was really nice is I was planning events that were 300-400 in terms of the size. That was a great learning as well. And also just to have a better insight into how different cultures host different events and weddings. I've planned a Persian wedding, been part of African events, Greek. So it's been really interesting to understand more. And I've definitely had a bit of a deep dive into Asian cuisine in terms of Indian food. So that was absolutely delicious. And again, a great experience. So I think what I've loved about each of the roles really is that in each of them, I've been able to learn new things and grow and develop.
So can you tell us who's been a valuable role model in your life?
I would say I've had different role models at different stages. When I was at the Ritz, my role model was my manager, Pamela. I owe a lot of my training early on to her in terms of delivering perfection, you know, reading emails, using the right language, the way to speak to clients. You know, I think that's something that my training and time at the Ritz has always stayed with me. I would say John Williams, the executive chef at the Ritz, has also been a real massive support. And again, I've learned so much from him in terms of food, you know, again, demanding excellence as well. You know, everything that he does is exquisite. And at Marriott, again, I've had different people who I really admire and respect. Anders, the sales director at the Sheraton, you know, just working with him on different accounts again was a huge learning, and I have so much respect for him. And the general managers at the Sheraton, Justin Pinchbeck and Le Meridian, which is now called the Dilly, with James Oliver, again working with them was so great and so insightful, and understanding, seeing how they dealt with different situations was really interesting as well, and a great learning for me to be able to observe people who had so much knowledge and experience. And especially my manager at Marriott, Carol Bridges and Chloe Remy, again working with people in the industry who have been there for 10 years or more, or around about that time. You know, it's always really interesting to learn and see how the people do things.
And so looking more to the current day, how have you been spending your time during lockdown?
So at the moment, I'm just building my new website, and I'm just looking at planning ahead. So for the clients that I'm currently working with right now, we're just looking at different options and strategies. Their weddings are in the summer, this coming summer. So it's just looking at different options and strategies to wait and see with the different numbers, you know, what will happen. I think it's important to be prepared emotionally for different options and strategies. I'm just trying to keep busy. So, you know, doing some courses online, preparing the website, trying to maintain my social media. I think it's really important to keep moving, keep growing, keep evolving. And I'll be attending the Bride Luck conference later today as well.
You're always so positive every time that I speak with you. How do you maintain that enthusiasm and motivation, especially at the moment in the current environment?
Not going to lie, the last 2 months have been really hard, and it's not possible to always stay positive. There are moments, especially in the last month, where I have done nothing. And for personal reasons, I haven't focused on work for family and different personal reasons. And I think it's important to be kind to yourself and to just say, look, you know, to listen to your body. You know, if you're really tired, then manage your day, manage your expectations. Don't set yourself tasks which are not possible. And also, you know, if one day, you know, you're really not feeling it and you need a day for yourself to take care of yourself, then I think it, you know, listen to yourself. I really like planning. So, you know, I try and have structure to my day. Yesterday I was fortunate to be able to go horse riding with a friend. So that was really nice. And I think probably one of the reasons that I'm in a really good mood today, but a bit stiff and a bit sore. But, you know, I think it's important to keep busy and have things to look forward to.
Who is it that you rely on to keep going, or, you know, your rock or your support group, your fan club?
It's not just one person. I feel really blessed to have a really good group of friends from school, university, and then also a really good group of friends within the industry, which, you know, count yourself as one of them. Yeah. You know, and I think I think it's those friendships, you know, that's what motivates me. And also as well, when I'm working, I'm motivated knowing that I'm making a difference.
Mm.
And I think that really drives me. You know, I'm not just doing something which is going to go into someone's inbox and nothing is going to materialize. There is an end result, and that end result, it means a lot to the client. So that's what kind of drives me and keeps me going.
With so many of us working from home, we're all quite obsessed with where we work, how we work. You know, are you in a shed? Have you got a home office? Are you in the corner of a kitchen? Can you just tell us a bit about like your current workspace, how it works for you?
So at the moment, when I was in London the last few months, I definitely had a dedicated desk. I had all my things there and I really liked the structure. And right now in Spain, I don't have a dedicated area. I kind of, if it's sunny, I'll sit on the terrace. If it's not, I'll sit by the fire. So I've kind of been moving around a little bit, but I will, when I find my most comfortable place, I do think it is important to have a dedicated working area so then you can switch off when you're not there.
So what's a favourite part of your day?
Being with my dogs. I'm very naughty. I let two of them sleep in my bed. And they're just so sweet, their personality. And, you know, they in the mornings, they're like, come on, you need to get up, feed me, let's go out. And I don't know, they really get me going and bring a lot of joy to my life.
And tell me who you would invite to a dream dinner party.
Do you know what? I would invite my friends from within the industry. Mm-hmm. I've missed them so much. I think it's been a year since I've seen everybody. Mm-hmm. I think it's you know, I think the last time I saw everyone was at the Kimpton showcase last February. And I just love to invite everyone to a big dinner party, all the friends within the industry. I think we got so used to spending so much time together with different networking events and different evenings and things. And yeah, I miss seeing people in person.
If you could have a superpower, what would it be?
To not need to sleep.
Ah.
Then you could do everything. You'd have time to do everything. Sometimes I feel like the day finishes and I'm like, I haven't done everything I wanted to do. I haven't achieved everything that my to-do list today. And I kind of think if I didn't sleep, I could just carry on.
So who would play you in a film of your life?
At school, people said I was a bit like Lucy Liu just because I'm half Asian, but I'm really not sure.
So what's been your guilty pleasure during lockdown?
Crisps.
Oh.
I normally watch a TV show or a movie in the evening and I normally open a packet of crisps and munch, and I always say, oh, I'll just have a little bit. you know, maybe an hour later, there's none left in the packet. So,
what would be your dream event to work on or venue to work for?
The dream venues to work for would be somewhere like Spencer House, the Langham Hotel, the Peninsula Hotel. They're all stunning venues that I, you know, really risk, like, just what they offer the client is incredible. Or what, maybe Kensington Palace, somewhere like that. I think for me, that would be a dream come true in terms of a venue. Dream event? I don't know. I don't think there is a dream event per se, but I think there is a dream client in the sense that there's someone that perhaps has budget to do things that are different,
mm-hmm.
or things that you've not, or work with vendors that, or suppliers that you've never worked with before. And is perhaps a bit more free so that you can really go the extra mile and do something fun and different.
Okay. And if you could live anywhere in the world, where would it be and why?
I would be here in Spain. Why? Because my dogs are here. It's where I grew up. I have a lot of very special memories. Mm. And, you know, it's just so idyllic and I just love being outside. So I'm really happy to be here right now.
Can you tell us about an event that you thought might not come off or you really had to think on your feet to make it work?
There's been one or two brides and grooms that I've worked with that have been very, they wanted to do a lot of things DIY.
Mm-hmm.
They were such a lovely couple. But as a venue, at that time I was working for Marriott, as a venue, there are certain things that do not fall under necessarily our remit. Mm. And things like decorating the room with flowers and setting up candelabra is not something that the team is really, it shouldn't really fall to their responsibility, just in case it doesn't come out exactly as the client would want it. So that for me is something always to be a bit careful with. Mm. So that was quite a challenge, you know, managing the client's expectations and also making sure that we as a team didn't promise to deliver something that in reality might be a bit challenging or might not end up to be the way the client wanted. With that particular client as well, they didn't follow my advice in terms of the timeline. Mm-hmm. Traffic coming from the church, traffic around London, having photos around after the church, they thought they could fit it in a much shorter space of time when I always think in that those scenarios it's better to leave more time in the to plan it in, you know, or at least a realistic time frame, and the ceremony overran slightly, so everything else overran, and then those things did take a bit longer. You know, Saturday traffic in London is never good. Mm. And so everything was delayed, which was fine because we did preempt it, but we did manage it on the day, and we did slightly kind of, I was texting the best man, I was like, have you left the church yet? And they were like, no. So it was we could manage it on the day, but I think those tiny things are things that you could preempt in advance. Mm. A bit more, you know, just by if they had gone with my advice. Mm. And it would have been less of a, it would have been less chaotic on the day.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
You know, we completely changed all the timings and everything was delayed, and the florist was in a bit of a fluster because they couldn't take the flowers from the church and bring them to the venue, and they couldn't find the venue. I'm not sure what happened with their sat nav. So it was all, and they were stressed, and it was all just becoming you know, a bit of a thing. So I think that was an issue, really. I think it's important if you have a planner or you know, somebody involved in advising and guiding you, that you really listen to their advice. You know, if you choose not to as the client, that is your prerogative. But you know, I think it is important to take on board the advice of someone who has experience in these matters.
Absolutely. So what do you think makes a wedding or event planner stand out from the crowd?
And I think it's really important for them to be able to listen and connect with the client. Mm. And to be efficient. You know, everything in this day and age is everyone expects a fast answer. You know, we as a society, you know, even myself, you know, I order a lot of things on Amazon Prime, connect comes the next day. You know, we all want things quite immediately. So I think it's really important that, you know, you respond as your client expects you to respond, or you set the expectations so that they know that you're there for them, or they're not kept waiting, because I think that can really irritate people. You know, especially working with suppliers sometimes, you know, if you're waiting a few days for a response, you know, I think it's important to manage the client and the planner's expectations. You know, thanks for your email, reply, you know, I'm busy today, but I'll reply next day. So I think it's really important, that whole element of managing expectations and the relationship. And then as well, just listening to the client and putting forward ideas that actually matches what they say.
Mm.
And also I think understanding their budget, because there's no point proposing ideas, venues, suppliers that don't match what they want and are out of their budget price-wise.
And final question, we've done it. What are you most looking forward to when we go back to normal, or as close to normal as we can post-COVID?
I think there are two things I'm looking forward to. One is just being able to see friends, family, wonderful people within the industry without worrying or without thinking, you know, we have to sit outside or have to keep a distance or can I hug you? I haven't seen my sister in a year and the kids. I mean, I've seen them on FaceTime, but it's just, I think that element of being able to come together and just celebrate. And the second thing is I'm involved in the planning of the Royal Versailles Ball, which will be taking place later this year. So I'm really excited for the planning and the organisation of it. We'll be over 1,000 people in the Palace of Versailles.
Wow.
So
wow.
I'm really excited.
Wow. Look, thank you so much for playing 20 questions. It was really really interesting to learn a bit more about you. And hopefully we'll be seeing, you know, each other and everyone very soon.
Oh, Maria, I really hope so. And thank you so much for asking me. It's been so much fun.
You're welcome. Take care. Bye.